I started doing karate when I was 15, and there was a little jiu-jitsu class that I did like once a week at the gym I was at, and then I met a friend of mine, and he told me about Ralph Gracie, and I came in and met Kurt. I was 18, and got on the mat, and Kurt was awesome, and just got my ass kicked by everybody, and I knew that's where I had to be, so I moved to the city and started training twice a day, and just got into it. Fell in love with jiu-jitsu.
You moved to the city for jiu-jitsu?
Yeah, I moved to the city just to train. Because I was commuting from up north, commuting an hour to train. And so finally I was like, screw it, I'm just going to move in here. I moved in with my first two roommates, Gabe Rudiger and this guy James Meadows. And the three of us train and would fight each other at the house and, you know, get into wrestling matches at home and go back to the gym and train every day. So it was just like I was immersed in jiu-jitsu. It's all I did. You know, it's all I thought about. And started competing all the time and started doing well in competition, you know, just progressed. And Ralph and Kurt really took a liking to me and showed me, you know, showed me everything they knew. Kurt was like my second dad, like my jiu-jitsu dad, so just like my second home, you know. And then after that, progressed to MMA. It just seemed like the next step was to start fighting. So it's really what I wanted to do from the beginning, but Ralph was really then I met a friend of mine, and he told me about Ralph Gracie, and I came in and met Kurt. I was 18, and got on the mat, and Kurt was awesome, and just got my ass kicked by everybody, and I knew that's where I had to be, so I moved to the city and started training twice a day, and just got into it. Fell in love with jiu-jitsu.
You moved to the city for jiu-jitsu?
Yeah, I moved to the city just to train. Because I was commuting from up north, commuting an hour to train. And so finally I was like, screw it, I'm just going to move in here. I moved in with my first two roommates, Gabe Rudiger and this guy James Meadows. And the three of us train and would fight each other at the house and, you know, get into wrestling matches at home and go back to the gym and train every day. So it was just like I was immersed in jiu-jitsu. It's all I did. You know, it's all I thought about. And started competing all the time and started doing well in competition, you know, just progressed. And Ralph and Kurt really took a liking to me and showed me, you know, showed me everything they knew. Kurt was like my second dad, like my jiu-jitsu dad, so just like my second home, you know. And then after that, progressed to MMA. It just seemed like the next step was to start fighting. So it's really what I wanted to do from the beginning, but Ralph wasn't really into it. He wanted me to get my black belt first and really nail down my jiu-jitsu before I started fighting. And once I got my brown belt, I was like, all right, I'm gonna fight. So I said, okay, take a fight. So I took a fight and started fighting MMA, and that kind of just got into that. Trained gi-less all the time, kind of stuck away from the gi a little bit, but I'm still a jiu-jitsu guy. Stepping away from it a little bit. I'm just really busy with my business, the tattoo shop right now, and I don't have the time to train like I need to fight. So I'm trying to get back into gi, and I want to do the worlds next year and kind of re-explore jiu-jitsu. I really want to, you know, achieve more in the gi, so thinking about doing that.
I heard that back in the day you were all about like animal rights. I heard you had a bunch of animal rights tattoos.
I did, dude. I started jiu-jitsu.